You simply pick the vehicle of your choice, receive your price up front, and you're driving home. It's that easy at South Bay Toyota, located at the 405 freeway and Western Avenue.
Where the turf meets the surf, down at Old Del Mar, take a plane, take a train, take a car. There's a smile on every face and a winner in each race. Where the turf meets the surf, at Del Mar.
Daybreak at Del Mar's back of the clubhouse terrace every Saturday and Sunday during the meet from 7:30 till 9 a.m. Enjoy complimentary coffee and watch morning workouts with commentary from Michelle Yu. First post-time opening weekend is 2 p.m. Tickets can be purchased online at dmtc.com or call 858-792-4242 for details. Use your seat tickets for free admission.
Where the turf meets the surf at Del Mar.
Welcome back to Where the Surf Meets the Turf. Welcome back to Del Mar.
Thoroughbred owners and breeders, if you're looking for a full-service, professionally managed facility right here in Southern California, look no further than George Yeager's BG Thoroughbred Farm in Hemet. From conception to starting gate, from breeding, mare care and foaling, to racetrack preparation and state-of-the-art rehabilitative care, BG Thoroughbred Farm is the place for you. Owned by George Yeager and managed by Marcos Menavar, BG Thoroughbred Farm is located atop 51 acres of prime sandy loam and is just 90 minutes from Santa Anita, Del Mar, and Los Alamitos. With a 5/8 mile training track that includes a starting gate, BG has 28 pastures with year-round grass, along with a layup barn that includes runout pens and numerous sand pens for turnouts that'll keep your horse safe and ready to return to racing. For more information or to schedule a tour, visit bgthoroughbredfarm.com or give Marcos Menavar a call at 951-654-9100. BG Thoroughbred Farm in Hemet.
Now, more than ever, it pays to own a cowbred. Owners of a registered California bred maiden shall be paid $17,500 owner's bonus for winning a maiden allowance race in Southern California and a $10,000 owner's bonus for winning a maiden allowance race in Northern California. These bonus awards are in addition to all regular purse monies won and will be paid within 30 days after the win. California bred $50,000 or less maiden claiming winners will be eligible for the current $40,000 or less starter races too. Take advantage of these tremendous new incentive programs by breeding and buying cowbreds. For information, call the California Thoroughbred Breeders Association at 626-445-7800. That's 626-445-7800. Or log on to ctba.com. And remember, it pays to own a cowbred.
Racing fans, happy days are here again at Sammy's Original Off-Track Wagering as they are now fully open for indoor dining and wagering. That's right, Sammy's Original in Lake Forest, where the 5 and the 405 collide, is once again open for off-track wagering on tracks around the country 7 days a week. Just exit east at Lake Forest Drive, make an immediate right onto Lake Center Drive, and you're home at Sammy's. Sammy's Original Sports Bar and Racebook with over 120 televisions, great food, a full bar that includes 16 beers on tap, also offers two fully appointed outdoor patios. Make plans now to go racing at Sammy's Original in Lake Forest. For more information, call 949-716-2367. Get comfortable. Get into Sammy's.
The best of quarter horse racing continues at Los Alamitos Racecourse every Saturday and Sunday night. The nighttime summer action at Los Alamitos will feature California Breeders Champions Weekend on July 30th and 31st. Juveniles face off in the Governor's Cup Futurity on July 30th, led by fastest qualifier Frivolous and kindergarten finalist Mornings with Maria. On July 31st, She Goes Up will look to sweep the Governor's Cup Series with a win in the Derby. No filly has swept the Governor's Cup Series since the Great Corona Cash in 1997 and 98, plus the Spencer Childers Championship, the Matron Stakes for Mares, and many more stakes races. And remember, Los Alamitos is open for daytime simulcasting 7 days a week. Enjoy the great daytime action from Del Mar, Saratoga, and more. The best of racing, the best of quarter horse racing, always at Los Alamitos, California Breeders' Champions Weekend, July 30th and 31st.
There they go. O'Hara lost the rider. Native Diver is going to the front. Gamely and Rising Market nose and nose. And Gamely is the winner by a nose. Rising.
Mockery has the weight advantage. Farm Away has the class. Which one's going to win it? Farm Away, Mockery, Farm Away.
It's Thoroughbred Los Angeles. Hosted by Mike Willman. Thoroughbred LA is brought to you by the Del Mar Thoroughbred Club. Come experience California's highest purses, where the turf meets the surf, through September 11th. By Uncle Chemo's Kona Coffee. Take it from Tyler Bays and Juan Hernandez. Uncle Chemo's, you'll be glad you did. By David Wilson's Toyota of Orange, South Bay Toyota, and Villa Ford of Orange. Come see their great selection of new and used vehicles and experience David Wilson's world-class customer service. By BG Thoroughbred Farm in Hemet. Come see us. Visit our website or schedule an in-person farm tour. BG Thoroughbred Farm, just 90 minutes from Santa Anita, Los Alamitos, and Del Mar. By Sammy's Original Off-Track Wagering, where the 5 and the 405 collide at Lake Forest Drive. By the California Thoroughbred Breeders Association. Catch a cowbred and experience that golden feeling. By Sunset Suites on Pacific Coast Highway in Sunset Beach. Beat the heat and get into Sunset Suites. By Bruce Finkelstein's BetOnBruce.com. By the Rags and Sheets, the number one choice of top jockey agents, trainers, and players like you nationwide. By the all-new Derby Room at Fairplex Park. Great food, great customer service, and free parking and admission 7 days a week at the Derby Room. And by the South Point Hotel, Casino, and Spa in Las Vegas. Call Mary Jungers and make your reservations now at 866-791-7626. Now, here's Mike Willman.
Thank you, Leilani Mabrie, and a very pleasant good morning, everybody. Great to be back with you. Opening weekend where the turf meets the surf at Del Mar. And what an incredible opening 2 days it has been. All-time record opening day handle on Friday, $23.1 million. They followed that up yesterday. Yesterday, 110 horses entered the run before scratches over 10 races. And Del Mar, all sources, Parimutuel handle yesterday, $23.2 million, and some outstanding performances on the racetrack. The Irish bred Balkanov took the opening day Oceanside under Umberto Rispoli, who it looks like is going to be riding first call for D'Amato at this meet. And boy, that could be a very mutually beneficial situation, as we are seeing. Rispoli came back in the last race yesterday, the main event, the Grade 2 $200,000 San Clemente, and he pointed Bella Bell to victory at 3-1, returning $8 to win. And boy, Bella Bell, most impressive. Co-feature yesterday, Avenue de France, trained by Leonard Powell, ridden by Juan Hernandez, took the $100,000 Ocenitas, a tremendous ride from Hernandez. And Juan Hernandez, the leading rider through 2 days. He tripled both on opening day and yesterday. The rider's race going to be very interesting. We've got a rider of note coming into Del Mar today. He's going to be riding full-time throughout the meet for the most part, and that is Florent Garou, and he's on six today. They're all live. A couple of very interesting first-time starters. We're going to have his agent, Doug Bradar, in just a few minutes. And, of course, Florent Garou, Brad Cox, Joe Hardoon, Al Gould and company teamed up yesterday to take down the Grade 1 Haskell at Monmouth Park. And in so doing, this is incredible, and it certainly speaks to the depth of this three-year-old crop this year. Cyberknife is now the only multiple Grade 1 winner thus far in 2022. And a very happy guy on that account joins us right now, Jonathan Hardoon of the Rags and Sheets. Hey, John, good morning.
Good morning, Mike. How are you?
Good. Congratulations. Sensational win by Cyberknife. An absolutely tremendous ride from Guru. I looked at it again this morning, and, you know, he had a lot of horse under him. It looked to me like this horse took him, you know, up the rail there, heading to the far turn, and then Flo had to kind of let him idle there from the quarter pole to the 3/16. He was able to save ground in so doing, and then he kicked on and outran Taiba late. I thought Taiba had a good trip. I know there's some speculation, and maybe he didn't have the best of it. But yesterday, I thought Cyberknife was the best horse. Take nothing away from Taiba. I mean, I think that was only his fourth career start, right? Ridden by Mike Smith for Mr. Baffert. That was a grade one showdown, and congrats on the big win, John.
Yeah, it was really terrific. And you're right, Mike. What a ride. I mean, at the top of the stretch, Drew decided to go inside, and that was certainly the difference. If he doesn't get through there, Taiba obviously wins. And Frank, listening to the call, certainly sounded, he thought Taiba was home. And we just rebroke inside, and really so exciting and just happy for everybody involved. You know, this horse was supposed to be really something special. I remember last summer talking to Jay Prittman, telling him that my son bought a horse for his gold square and watched he's going to make the Derby. And I'm sorry, he thought I was crazy, but
yeah,
he made the Derby. And
unreal.
Yesterday was the first time that he really ran a race, you know, without any of his antics. He, like, grew up, you know, and it was, he didn't get respect at the windows off the numbers. He ran a 6 last time out, which was as good as anybody else, and really just a terrific ride and a terrific, terrific race. It really was.
And an incredible job, I think, by an incredible trainer. You know a lot more about him than I do. He's never without the baseball cap. His name is Brad Cox, and I thought I enjoyed listening to the post race yesterday. It just seems like a big key with this horse was they didn't get too ambitious off the disappointing effort in the Kentucky Derby. Now, he had won the Arkansas Derby impressively, came into Churchill Downs, and you know, it just wasn't his day. Instead of going in the Belmont, they opted for the mat win. They stayed home at Churchill Downs on June 12th, gave him a little more time, got a confidence builder in him. Yeah, he was all out to win, but I think that was a huge key for this horse.
Well, Brad Cox is as good as it gets, Mike. You know, he's up there with Fletcher and Brown and Baffert. He's really stamped himself as a terrific trainer, and he just does a great job. And Cyberknife is back at Saratoga this morning, and hopefully 5 weeks from yesterday, he will be running in the Travers, and everybody is all pumped and excited. You know, the Haskell was an extremely important win to the owner. He grew up in Jersey. He spent 30-some-odd years there. He still has the box, even though he lives in Saratoga. He's had a box there for 37 years.
Right.
He never gave it up. His friends go there every weekend. So it was just, it was amazing, and you know, it was a dream come true for that level of connections, I'm sure.
And as they said, it's on now to the Breeders' Cup. It's a win and you're in. His ticket is stamped for the Classic. Really something. Now, listen, a lot of people talking about the oppressive heat, the humidity there in upstate New York. But I just checked the weather before we're coming on. John, it was kind of a mild 85. The humidity only at 52%. Is that going to hold?
Well, hopefully it just gets hotter every day as the day goes on here. And, you know, it could rain at any time. That's the problem with this heat. All of a sudden you get a pop-up fungus shower, and it kind of screws up the
steam
whole
bath.
But so far, so good. And only one of those, it happened, I think, on opening day, actually, before the first race. But other than that, the weather's been pretty good. It's hot. It's certainly hot. Don't get me wrong. But no real rain, and that's good, because when it starts raining in Saratoga, it can last a few days or weeks, believe me.
Right. Now, look, you've got 10 today. You tee it up, regular post, 105 Eastern. We've only got you once this morning because we've only got a 90-minute show owing to the Angels pregame from Atlanta today, John. So we'll get an East and West pick from you. That said, I know you've been watching what's going on at Del Mar. To me, phenomenal competition. It's been safe. I'm knocking on wood as I say that. We're going to have Joe Harper join us at the top of the next hour. One thing I've enjoyed from home and a couple other places, the TVG coverage, to me, they went way over the top last year with the drone stuff, and they made Mike Joyce with a telestrator, you know, bang that thing after every race. The coverage this year, I really have enjoyed it. I mean, they got a full complement of talent there. Kurt Hoover is obviously one of them. Christina Oliveras. I mentioned Mike Joyce, Simon Bray, Todd Trupp, Christina Black, I should say. But Blacker. I've really, really enjoyed the coverage from Del Mar thus far, John.
Yeah, sometimes less is more, Mike, and, you know, let the horses be the stars.
Yes.
We don't need people sticking their two cents in. But listen, let's be honest. The fields are full. We have horses coming from everywhere. When you have 110 horses on a card, you're going to get payoffs. But what did the Pick 5 pay? $380,000.
Amazing.
Insane prices, and people love that. Listen, I'm not telling you it's easy. It's not easy. It's extremely difficult. The good news, though, Mike, hopefully all these horses that are shipping in, hopefully a lot of them get claimed and we rebuild the inventory for Southern California. You know, all these horses shipping in, even if we get 25% of them or something to stay, how great would that be?
Yeah, I know. And one thing, and I know it's early, not much sample size, just 2 days, but we all bemoan the proliferation of this batch betting, late odds changes. I do think the big fields, the depth, serves to mitigate that somewhat, John. Would you agree with that early on?
100%, Mike, because the fields are bigger and the money's not going to be that, you know, it's not going to stick out. A horse isn't going to go from 14-1 to 6-1. You know, maybe they'll go 14-10. That's at least feasible, you know. When you chop it in half, it's just terrible.
And
the worst thing they could do for the game.
The short fields really facilitate that unwittingly. All right, listen, let's put the ball on the tee. Best bet for Saratoga, then come out here to Del Mar. The water's fine.
Okay, let's go to the ninth race today at Saratoga. 5.5 furlongs on the turf, and I like the number 3 horse in here, Notte Bene. This is a 4-year-old filly from the Ian Wilkes barn. This horse gets a major rider switch day to Irod Ortiz. She had trouble last time out. She broke from the rail. She was shuffled back. Today she should get a much better trip. Irod Ortiz aboard to ride 5-1 on the morning line. I like number 3, Notte Bene, to win today's ninth race out at Saratoga.
Two separate words, N-O-T-A and then B-E-N-E, number 3, Notte Bene in race 9. Come on out to Del Mar. Who is it, John?
Let's look at the 7th race today, Mike. 1.5 miles on the turf. And let me tell you, Phil D'Amato has become the West Coast version of Chad Brown.
No doubt.
It's just deadly. I mean, you know, he ran 1-2-3 in a race yesterday. Anyway, he trains number 1, Greg Dar. This is a 5-year-old who had trouble in his last race at the start. Go watch the replay. Rider switch today, Ramon Vasquez. 1-1 at Del Mar, 1-1 at the distance, 8-1 on the morning line. I like number 1, Greg Dar, to win today's 7th race out at Del Mar.
JONHARDON.com. What's there, John?
3 best plays, $10. Full card, $25. Today we offer Monmouth, Saratoga, and Del Mar selections.
Hey, best to Joey. Congratulations on that huge win by Cyberknife in yesterday's Grade 1 Haskell at Monmouth. John, continued success, and we'll talk to you next week.
Thanks, Mike. Stay safe and be well.
10-4. All right, well, let's stay with the phones right now, and we're going to welcome aboard an old friend and one of the top jockey agents in the country right now. He's got one of the top young riders in the world by the name of Florent Garou. His name is Doug Bradar, and Flo is out here at Del Mar today, fresh off victory aboard Cyberknife, to ride 6 horses where the turf meets the surf. Doug Bradar, good morning. Thanks for making time.
Oh, you're very welcome. Good morning, Mike.
Good morning to you. First things first, you know, every now and again we see these jocks, they ride back east, they're supposed to make it out to San Diego, and there's a couple of hiccups with the travel plans. Is everything going according to the way you planned it? Will he be at Del Mar?
Very much so. Usually how we work it is he does all of his own travel. And he tells me when there's issues. I only hear from him when there's bad issues. So
okay.
I have not heard from him this morning. So to the best of my knowledge, he's on a plane flying right back to San Diego, a nonstop one from Newark.
No news, good news. A tremendous ride aboard Cyberknife yesterday. Your thoughts in watching that race and how good this horse is getting, Doug?
Yeah, we've had high hopes for the horse for a long time. I know Brad Cox and his team really felt that this was their Derby horse, and obviously he only beat a couple there. He was up close to that very hot pace, not setting the fractions, but probably a little too close, and it took the best of him. But we're very proud of him. He really shined yesterday and showed what he's all about. Flo gave him an amazing, brilliant ride. and couldn't be happier.
He's an amazing talent. What's the game plan for Del Mar?
Well, we have every intention of staying here, definitely through the meet. We will test the waters and see where we're at. I kind of wish we had made the announcement that we were coming a little bit sooner, but unfortunately, we waited a little bit later than we should have. But
yeah.
Book one is out, and we've got good business there. But hopefully, with book two, we will pick up some more now that people know we're here. And I'm reacquainting myself with quite a few of the horsemen and some of the new trainers that I'm not familiar with. So it's a learning process, but looks real promising.
Doug, you got Florent Garou on six today. I only want to talk about three of them. A couple of first-timers. The first one trained by Pete Miller, an Army of Light. And this guy is number five in race two at 6-1. It looks like, we see a bullet half mile from the gate at Santa Anita. Three works back on July 6th, 47-1. On paper, that looks pretty good. What do you know about this horse?
Well, I wish I could give more insight, to be perfectly honest with you. Flo has only been in town since Tuesday. We did not work this horse. All I can tell you is take a look at what you see, and that's what you get. I see, 2, 4, 6, 8, about 10 works. A real nice one at Santa Anita on July 6th, half and 47-1, handily from the gate. But, Peter, he puts him in the right spot. So
I have
faith that this horse will run his race and hopefully he gets a good, safe trip.
All right, Doug, next, a first-time starter for Bob Baffert. I love the name. Having a Meltdown, two-year-old first-timer by a Lionheart stallion by the name of Uncaptured and owned by some longtime clients, Mike Pegram, Carl Watson, Paul Whiteman. You see bullets kind of across the tab, primarily at Los Alamitos, but most recently a half at Santa Anita in 46 flat, best of 55 on July 15th. And the morning line maker John White has you as the 9-5 early favorite. Did Bob have a story with having a meltdown here in race four?
Once again, Flo has not worked this horse. This one's last work was at Santa Anita, but it's got to be pretty good. It was first of 55 workers. So we have faith in Bob. Just another one of those ones where you got to do the right thing and ride a two-year-old for Bob. So we're on him, and hopefully he's the right one.
Doug, suffice it to say, you're more than happy to take anything sight unseen for a guy like Baffert. Am I right or wrong?
Yeah, here was the situation. We arrived on the scene late. You know, when I have to give out calls for babies, am I able to study their pedigree, their work pattern, all the different things that go into, and usually I use, Flo's guidance. If we're going to be on a baby, he might have worked all three of the ones that I have to decide from. So
yeah,
a lot of these horses in these early races, the first couple of weeks of the meet, we may not end up working them. I'm not super familiar with them, and I just have to make the best decision that I can make.
Doug, last thing, you're on a very consistent French bred gelding by the name of Bran. Comes off a nice win down the hillside turf at Santa Anita in the Grade 3 Daytona, and he's going to be in today's restricted wicker. This one at a mile on grass. Juan Hernandez, no surprise, opting for the morning line favorite, smooth like straight. Now, he's got an outside box to overcome. It looks like a ton of speed in here. You might be the speed of the speed. Any thoughts on Bran here for John Sadler, the 7 horse today in what is race 9, the $100,000 Wicker Stakes?
Well, there is a pretty good story with Bran. We did actually get offered the mount on him in the turf sprint at Churchill Downs on Derby Day. And unfortunately, I had a prior commitment and I was unable to ride him. But, he ran incredible that day at 40-1, got beat less than 2 lengths. And, is surrounded by California winds. He obviously
right.
likes the downhill at Santa Anita and run some good races there. So, I'm hoping that we can maybe get the first jump on Smooth Like Straight, who's a very, very nice animal, and get her picture taken.
Terrific. Hey Doug, did you have a chance last thing to talk to Flo after yesterday's Haskell? And if so, maybe his thoughts on the way Cyberknife was able to win yesterday.
Yeah, I mean, he was tickle pink. It was a very, very great experience. Obviously, when you jump back in the Uber and you drive back to your hotel, he was going to finally get some sleep. But it was funny because I called him and he was actually leading the track. There was a press conference and all sorts of other stuff going on. So he had to put the phone down. He said, "Hold on for 1 second." And all of a sudden I hear in the background a lady and a gentleman talking to him. "Can we have your picture? We want to get our picture taken with you."
Nice.
"He won the Haskell, right? And can we get it? Can you autograph our program?" And I mean, he couldn't have been more polite to these people, and they obviously just caught him walking out of the jock suit with all of his hats. So, now he was obviously thrilled to death. We had a difficult decision to make this spring, for the Arkansas Derby, and I think it paid off. Hopefully, I think we picked the right horse now that we got the Haskell winner.
I think so. Doug Bradart, thanks so much. All the best to you and Florent Garut today and throughout the meet here at Del Mar. Thank you.
Thanks so much, Mike.
You bet. Folks, we've been away 2 weeks. I don't know about you, but I've missed Ron Flatter, a man on the move. He joins us right now en route from New Jersey back to his home base in Louisville, Kentucky. Ron, good morning. How's it going?
Live from the Richard Stockton rest stop on the New Jersey Turnpike. Hello?
Okay. Wow.
Aren't you excited? Can't you feel the excitement pulsing through the air?
Well, you had plenty of excitement yesterday. I mean, 14 races at Monmouth Park, and John Hardoon mentioned Frank Miramati. I just thought throughout the day, the guy does a phenomenal job. That is some kind of a marathon with all those graded stakes. And I should have mentioned with John, what about Flavion Pratt and Chad Brown? Four graded stakes wins yesterday. An abundance of storylines, Ron Flatter.
Well, yeah. And by the way, the best move that Frank Miramati made all week on Thursday morning was carrying a plastic container of cupcakes into the communications office at Monmouth Park.
Oh.
Stumbled, and they flew into the air. He caught them one-handed by the rim in a catch that was reminiscent of David Tyree in the Super Bowl, and he had the best save of the week, Frank Miramati. So I will give you that. But also, yeah, you're right. Yesterday, it wasn't the Haskell for a long time. It was the Chadskell, and he won not just the four graded stakes, but also the only other race he was in on a non-stake, won that one as well. That one was out without Flavian.
Yeah.
So they were on a roll, but then came the Haskell. And I'll give you a little interesting sidebar story that I put in my my game story at horseracingnation.com yesterday. Brad Cox, horse trainer of Cyberknife, and Chad's girlfriend and three jockeys had hired a private plane to take them from Saratoga to Monmouth. And very often, of course, you have an owner who will do that, like, say, Seth Klarman or something like that. Well, in this case, they decided to do it on their own. And here's Chad winning all these races. And I see Brad in the paddock, and he goes, "I better win one of these so I can at least pay for my share of the flight." Well, he darn well did at the very end. And so they wound up having to wait for him to come out of the news conference, and then he joined them for the drive right back to the airplane.
Right, right. Just an incredible day back there, of course. Disappointing run from the Haskell favorite, Jack Christopher, trained by Chad
right.
Brown. Any update on him this morning?
No, none. And again, for the most part, nobody was left at the track this morning because they'd all shipped back, flown back, what have you. They were all going back. So nothing new there. I mean, look, this is a horse. The big question on him was, could he get two turns? And now the answer may be no.
Right.
And the answer may be no. And we'll see what goes forward here. Will they send him? Will they go Travers with him and then maybe try to write this one off to just the optics of the track, which, of course, was rock hard. The track record for a mile and an eighth, which had been set by Spendabuck about almost 40 years ago, was broken twice in one day. And so that tells you something about the track, and maybe it'll be a little kinder and gentler on the hooves up at Saratoga if they decide to go out that direction with Jack Christopher. But that certainly was one thing to be taken into account there. Go ahead. Yeah.
Ron, is it the glib surface yesterday at Monmouth, do you think it's in part attributable to the hot, hot weather?
Yes, yes.
Yeah.
I absolutely would. They kept watering it all day. I mean, the water trucks were taking laps on it for 2 days. And I don't know if they ever stopped. The last time I saw water trucks on a main track like that was at Maydan, as often as all much as they were out. And I'm not exaggerating. I mean, they were out, they were out, they were out. But there's only so much you could do. That water was drying up. And so it was, it might as well have been the turnpike turned brown. So that was, I think that was a huge factor in terms of why the speed was so just white hot.
Encourage everybody, follow Ron Flatter at Horse Racing Nation. Ron, our time is short today. Do you have a best bet somewhere for us?
Well, let me see what I got for you here. In fact, I did make notes before I jumped on the turnpike. We're going to go to Del Mar for the Wicker, the ninth race, mile on the turf for three and up of the other vans. There's a ton of speed in this race. I don't think that can be overlooked. When you look at Smooth Like Straight, who's going to be the short price favorite, Storm the Court, Kentucky Pharaoh, Bran. So I'm going to look to try to make the speed fall apart and somebody to pick up the pieces. So I'm turning to the 6-1 shot for Phil D'Amato with Umbi Rispoli, and that's Gregorian Chan.
Yep.
If you look at the class drop here, for the last five non-graded stakes that this gelding has been in, he won. Now, the big question here is, can he actually get more than a mile? His only win at more than a mile was the first time he raced in the United States. But I think it sets up here for a horse coming off the pace against all this speed that the race could come back to him. Yes,
sure.
Huge question whether he can get more than a mile. But I think I'm going to say yes based on the speed in the race and based on the fact I'm getting a little bit of a price. 6-1 with Gregorian Chan in the Wicker.
Ron, isn't it great to see this kind of field size here in Southern California? I'm going to have Joe Harper on top of the next hour. I mean, to me, this is so good for all of us. It's just great to see, and it underscores the popularity, the viability of this game. It's just so hard to be dressing up an inferior product. The bettors know. And the money is finding its way to Del Mar, no doubt.
Here's my concern, though. At the beginning of the meet, it's easier because, of course, they have the time off. There were not races to be written for a lot of these horses at Los Al, and so they had a hankering to come back. I want to know what's going to happen in 2 or 3 weeks, and if it can sustain it, God bless, but I'm holding my breath a little bit. So I don't mean to be the rain of the cloud over everyone's parade, but that's what I'm looking at.
It'll be tough to sustain this fever pitch. No question about
it. Enjoy it while we can. I think that's your message, right?
Good call. All right. Hey, Ron, thank you so much. By the way, how many miles from Monmouth back to your home base there in Louisville?
About 700. And it's funny, I'm bringing some of the Ron Flatter Racing Pod with me. So I've already got guests lined up for next week based on this trip. So, I'm not leaving with an empty kit bag, as it were.
Well, you probably need a little help, too. I'm going to get you some Uncle Chemo's before your next roadie. How's that?
I like it.
Thank you very much. Ron, always a pleasure. Great to be back.
All right. Thanks, Mike.
Take care. We're going to step aside right now, coming back strong with John Lindo, Michael Rona from Los Alamitos, and we've got the two Tobys to close out hour one today with a 90-minute show, Toby Kallett from South Florida, and, of course, Toby Terrell from high atop the grandstand at Del Mar. That and more straight ahead. This is Thoroughbred L.A.
Radio.
AM 830.
Here at David Wilson's Villa Ford of Orange, we are here to help. We're open for sales and service, and with hundreds of vehicles to choose from, we are ready to assist you. And remember, you can get into that brand new Ford that you've always wanted without leaving the comfort of your home. Visit us at VillaFord.com to buy or lease your next car with great upfront pricing and a 100% online experience. Great financing and big retail enhancements on Ford Fusion and all popular Ford SUVs are available now. Check our website for tremendous pricing and financing on all Ford products, including America's best-selling vehicle, the F-150 pickup truck. David Wilson's Villa Ford of Orange. Call or click today at 714-509-5615. Or visit us at Villa Ford of Orange.
Attention Inland Empire Racing fans. Watching and wagering on the races just got easier. The Derby Room located at Fairplex Park is open and ready to serve you. Watch and wager in the newly renovated Derby Room on races across the country starting at 9 a.m. each Wednesday through Sunday. Televisions throughout the Derby Room will keep you up to date on all sporting events. Add in great food and a great atmosphere, and you'll have the ultimate horse player experience. For upcoming promotions, go to thederbyroom.com. Thederbyroom.com. See you at the Derby Room, 2201 North White Avenue in Pomona.
If you're looking for a quick weekend getaway, or maybe you've got friends and family coming in from out of town, check out Sunset Suites on Pacific Coast Highway in Sunset Beach. Conveniently located just south of Seal Beach Boulevard, Sunset Suites gives you ready beach access and your walking distance from outstanding breakfast, lunch, and legendary dining establishments right on Pacific Coast Highway. Just listen to some of the testimonials. It's a place like no other. Very quiet and a short walk to the beach. Very clean with all the amenities. The owners are amazing and always accommodating. We can't wait to go back. There you have it. Take the 605 to the 405 exit at Seal Beach Boulevard, west to Pacific Coast Highway, and you're there at 16401 PCH. Go ahead and get away for the day. Make your Sunset Suites reservations now at 562-592-2292. That's Sunset Suites at 562-592-2292. Life's a beach, so enjoy it at Sunset Suites. From the tropical rainforests of Hawaii's Big Island, nature has given us Uncle Chemo's Kona Coffee. Derived from a naturally occurring coffee bean that is only found in this precise altitude and climatic setting, Uncle Chemo's Kona Coffee ensures a perfect start to your day or any cherished moment from sunup to sundown. Every treasured coffee bean is the result of nearly 4 years of nurturing on the 57-acre family farm in the mountains above Halu'aloha, Hawaii. And unlike many other coffee beans from the Big Island, Uncle Chemo's is estate-grade and hand-roasted. This means all beans are grown, picked, roasted, and packaged on the farm to ensure the beans are the most balanced and as rich in flavor as possible. Uncle Chemo's Kona Coffee is now available on the mainland. To place an order, just visit UncleChemo'sKonaCoffee.com and look for our logo on the track and in the winner's circle, along with jockeys Juan Hernandez and Tyler Bays. Fans, visit our website, and you can see for yourself that Uncle Chemo's emanates from a true island paradise. Uncle Chemo's Kona Coffee, you can taste the aloha.
Where the turf meets the surf, where the turf meets the surf, down at Old Del Mar. You could be flying on an airplane, catching a fast train, or jumping in your car. Everybody's gonna have a smile on their face, cause somebody's gonna win every single time there's a race. Where the turf meets the surf down the Old Del Mar. Where the turf meets the surf, where the turf meets the surf down the Old Del Mar. Where the turf meets the surf.
Easy Thursdays are back. Free stretch run admission, free program, and a free seat every Thursday during the Del Mar meet. Add pints of Coors Light for just $6, and Thursdays are always a winning daily double. 4 o'clock Friday start July 29th with half-off signature drinks starting with the gates open until 2 hours after first post. You can pre-purchase seats at dmtc.com or call 858-792-4242 for details. See you where the surf meets the turf. Del Mar, still cool as ever.
Where the turf meets the surf down the Old Del Mar. Where the turf.
Hey everybody, this is Tyler Bays. If you can't get on fast horses like I do every morning, why not try the next best thing? Uncle Chemo's Kona Coffee. Uncle Chemo's, you'll be glad you did.
Hello, I'm Alan Mosnett, Toyota of Orange. For over 48 years, we've said you won't get a lemon at Toyota of Orange. That means you're driving a reliable Toyota. It also means you're getting the best deal on every new Toyota in stock. We're talking RAV4, Camry, Tacoma, Corolla, you name it. How have we stayed number one all these years? By turning lemons into oranges. Toyota of Oranges.
Well, you won't get a lemon from Toyota of Orange. Well, you won't get a lemon.
Angels Radio.
AM 830.
The way they kiss, they keep their boyfriends warm at night. I wish they owned the key.
Welcome back. Hour one, Thoroughbred Los Angeles. Opening weekend where the turf meets the surf at Del Mar. First post time every day excepting Fridays at 2 o'clock. Let's get down to Del Mar right now and say hello to John Lindo. Hey, John, good morning.
Good morning, Michael. We've been burning through the And Uncle Kimo's down here working through this weekend. It's a lot of fun.
A lot of fun. Great racing. The numbers are incredible. All-time record. Opening day handled 23.1 million. Came back yesterday with 23.2. I mentioned briefly with Jonathan Hardoon, I've enjoyed the TVG coverage. You're probably not watching because you're there in the press box, but very remiss in not mentioning a guy, I think, an outstanding part of their crew, and that's Dave Weaver. You know, we had a long inquiry following the San Clemente, and Dave was kind of advocating, you know, he thought in a very tough call that Lucky Girl, the 11 with Joe Bravo, should be disqualified, not Lady TV, or Lady T, rather, with Victor Espinosa. Turned out the stewards agreed with him. It was a tough call, a lengthy interview, but the point I'm making is it's been good TV in addition to great racing, John. I really mean that.
Oh, it has been. You know, big fields, and they're running hard down here. The services are terrific. On the main track, they're running fast, but all you can just see the horses getting over and accelerating.
Yes.
It's fair. You know, Jessica Piper won from dead last in a mile race opening day. So you can win from anywhere on the track, and, you know, the rails are down right now on the turf course, big wide turf course, and they're coming from all angles here on the grass. So it really is a lot of fun, Mike, and you know, the fans are showing up, too. The late pick five pool yesterday, $1.28 million.
Wow.
The late pick four, $985,000. And we've already had, the late pick five on Friday was $93,000 was the payoff. And yesterday's early pick five was $383,000. So there are some life-changing scores available out there.
Yeah, that's what people want, no question about it. We're always advocating for the California breds. Boy, we had a cowbred get bet down some kind of big time yesterday, John, and that was the big wham in race eight yesterday. Got off at 40 cents on the dollar with Juan Hernandez, paid $2.80 to win, trained by Luis Mendez, owned by a guy who's been around the game a long time, Michael Bello. You think of him with the mighty mare Megahertz. But with all the incentives, John, can you the purse, $80,000, but that's just the beginning of the story for the big wham, what they were able to pull off the table yesterday.
Well, absolutely. Okay, so you're running for the $80,000 purse. And at Del Mar this summer, if you race maidens on the dirt, straight maiden races or maiden 62,500, you run for an additional 25%. So add another $20,000 to
Jeez.
That.
Wow.
And since he started in Kentucky, he ran second in the Kentucky Juvenile before coming out to California. He's a ship and win horse. You add another 50%, another $40,000. So he's running for $140,000 yesterday. He gets up, wins by a half length. And so on top of all that purse money, he's going to get a check from the California Thoroughbred Breeders Association for $17,500. You know, you had the winner of the San Clemente running for a $200,000 purse. Well, the big wham ran for the second biggest pot of the day.
It's just phenomenal, you know.
It's unbelievable. I mean, what a way to get at. And congratulations to trainer Luis Mendez. And then, again, this is a horse by the California Stallion, Mr. Biggs, is at Legacy Ranch. He was actually sold in Washington, but because he's by a California Stallion, he's allowed to run in cowbird races. So the connections, they took advantage of
every
opportunity.
Yeah. That is, talk about the way to do it, huh? And not only that, I didn't hear it directly, but I heard a couple of guys on TV just passing it along. I believe Kurt Hoover had opined, and looking at the tape of the Kentucky Juvenile, that the big wham had an eye to the ship and win situation out here at Del Mar. He ran second, beat a length.
Yeah, and, even Paul Redham sent out a couple of first-time starters, cowbirds out there, to get a race in at Churchill Downs, and now they're running for all that money when they come back here to face the cowbirds. So the ownership, the breeders, they're taking notice of these programs, and they're doing what they can to take advantage of those first bonuses. I mean, those numbers, you got to give hats off to the Del Mar Racing Office for being creative and being aggressive,
yeah.
And the horsemen are responding.
Exactly. And I also want to note, you know, hey, along with the Breeders' Cup coming back to Santa Anita in 2023, that's good news for all of us. We're also going to have this ship and win program continuing on at Santa Anita. Obviously, the objective is to get a lot of these horses that came out here for DMTC to stay for Santa Anita. They're still eligible.
Exactly. They come out here. If they're in good form, you stick around. You get another bonus when you go up to Santa Anita.
Yeah.
I mean, This is an incredible program, and you can see by the field sizes. Yesterday, by my count, Mike, they had 19 chip and win horses run on the card. You know what that does to boost field size. And three of them won. So yeah, they're getting paid. And so congratulations. Again, this is a program that works. And we're not only the horsemen are benefiting, but the horse players, because we've got a different set of races to play now.
Right. And the TOC, a big part of this as well. John, our time is short. Want to mention Mary Junger's at the South Point. I know folks go on there, they can get the Linda report no matter how hot it is outside. I think you said yesterday it's like 76, fast and firm in the race and in the sports book. They're at the South Point, John.
Perfect conditions. You got the hot dog cart right behind the race book. Grab a hot dog and a cold beverage and take on Del Mar today. If you want to get out there anytime soon, give Mary Junger's a call, 866-780-7223. Ask for the Thoroughbred LA Horse Player Race.
Can we make some money today down at Del Mar?
Let's go down to the 11th and final today. In the 11th race, number one, Miss Maddie B was absolutely wiped out at the start last time. Got parked wide after that. Throw out her last race. She has a good race over the Del Mar Turf Course on her resume. I think from the rail post, she'll save ground with a clean trip at 12-1. She's live coming back. Number one, Miss Maddie B, 11th and final at Del Mar.
John, see you down there real soon. Look forward to catching you on radio again this coming Saturday, 9-10, with Jay Pribman and Bob Ike. Thank you so much and good luck.
All right. Thanks, Mike. Good luck today.
You bet. We'll close this segment out, head down Cotella, and say hello to the voice of Los Alamitos, Michael Rona, getting up a little bit early because Orlando Gutierrez has the day off. Hey, Michael, g'day.
G'day, mate. How would you be?
We're fine. I hope you're going to get plenty of sleep because you guys are going late again these days with Del Mar with these big cards. Of course, 2 o'clock start down there. I think first post for you guys is at 7:35, and I looked the last race goes. Post time scheduled tonight, the 10th and final at Los Al, 11:08 Pacific.
Yes, with the program culminating in a pair of trials to the Golden State Derby. So it will be a long, late night tonight at Los Alamitos, but some good quality on display. Apart from those Derby trials, race six is an allowance for fillies and mares, but quite clearly it's a stakes quality allowance, Mike. Some really nice fillies and mares are signed up in the sixth. Should be a good betting card.
Okay, looking forward to that. And again, you guys have 10 of them tonight. Where are we going for radio, Michael?
Well, the Golden State Derby trials, I think, are quite different in their makeup. The ninth, the first of them, features even money favorite Scoops Dynasty, 3-for-3 this year. He's the Winter Derby winner from February and very, very hard to beat. But the 10th is a much more open, contentious race. Morning line favorite is number 4, A Famous Ribbon, who finished fourth in Scoops Dynasty's Winter Derby. Hasn't run since April. I took a look at his gate work. They're all available for free at losalamitos.com. From June 25, and he lugged in badly early. I just don't know that he's going to be fully cranked up. The fastest 10 qualifiers will make the final to this race. I think he might just be worth trying to beat. There's several other chinks in the armor of other contenders. Daytona 1000's in great form. I just have a slight distance query on him or her at the 400 yards. Set Forward has won 5 of 7. But hasn't run this year and doesn't have a gate work. Freight Train Skew is another one in contention on the morning line, has reeled off 4 straight wins in Phoenix, but failed in both starts locally. Look, I'm with Dasher Dynasty number 8. I like the post position draw, 7-2 on the morning line. This horse has only 1 win from 8 starts, but 5 seconds, 3 of them beaten a nose. Another second place finish was an excellent half-length defeat by the very talented Whiskey Glasses in a trial to the Golden State Million Futurity late last year. I like the fact Dasher Dynasty has had a run off the bench, beaten a nose in an allowance earlier this month. And I think Dasher Dynasty at 7-2 is decent value from a good post. And let me just mention, Mike, that number 5, Unavailable, is worth playing around with in the exotics at 10-1. Often is unlucky and compromised at the start, but has some long shot placings to her credit. And she can get amongst the minor placings without surprising me. I I kind of fancy the 8.5 exacta.
Okay, terrific. And again, post time for the 10th and final set at 11:08 Pacific tonight. Michael, have a great night. Get some sleep. Thank you so much and good luck.
Sure, mate. And Burgard Sports Bar, Vessels Club and the Grandstand at Losail are all opening at 9:30 this morning. Apart from the Del Mar simulcasting, fans can watch and wager on the big rainbow security from Ruidoso.
Okay, terrific. Thanks so much, Michael.
Cheers.
Michael Rona, the voice of Los Alamitos, will take our final timeout this hour, coming back with the Tobys. Toby Callett from South Florida and Toby Terrell from Del Mar. Don't go away.
Angels Radio.
AM 830.
Hello, I'm Alan Mosnett, Toyota of Orange. For over 48 years, we've said you won't get a lemon at Toyota of Orange. That means you're driving a reliable Toyota. It also means you're getting the best deal on every new Toyota in stock. We're talking RAV4, Camry, Tacoma, Corolla, you name it. How have we stayed number one all these years? By turning lemons into oranges. Toyota of Oranges.
Well, you won't get a lemon from Toyota of Orange.
If you're looking for a quick weekend getaway, or maybe you've got friends and family coming in from out of town, check out Sunset Suites on Pacific Coast Highway in Sunset Beach. Conveniently located just south of Seal Beach Boulevard, Sunset Suites gives you ready beach access and your walking distance from outstanding breakfast, lunch, and legendary dining establishments right on Pacific Coast Highway. Just listen to some of the testimonials. It's a place like no other. Very quiet and a short walk to the beach. Very clean with all the amenities. The owners are amazing and always accommodating. We can't wait to go back. There you have it. Take the 605 to the 405 exit at Seal Beach Boulevard, west to Pacific Coast Highway, and you're there at 16401 PCH. Go ahead and get away for the day. Make your Sunset Suites reservations now at 562-592-2292. That's Sunset Suites at 562-592-2292. Life's a beach, so enjoy it at Sunset Suites. Racing fans, happy days are here again at Sammy's Original Off-Track Wagering, as they are now fully open for indoor dining and wagering. That's right, Sammy's Original in Lake Forest, where the 5 and the 405 collide, is once again open for off-track wagering on tracks around the country 7 days a week. Just exit east at Lake Forest Drive, make an immediate right onto Lake Center Drive, and you're home at Sammy's. Sammy's Original Sports Bar and Racebook, with over 120 televisions, great food, a full bar that includes 16 beers on tap, also offers two fully appointed outdoor patios. Make plans now to go racing at Sammy's Original in Lake Forest. For more information, call 949-716-2367. Get comfortable. Get into Sammy's.
Hi, Bill Coyne of South Bay Toyota. Whether you shop online at southbaytoyota.com or in person, we'll make it easy for you to save time and money. South Bay Toyota is located just off the 405 freeway at Western Avenue, where Torrance and Gardena meet. South Bay Toyota.
The best of quarter horse racing continues at Los Alamitos Racecourse every Saturday and Sunday night. The nighttime summer action at Los Alamitos will feature California Breeders' Champions Weekend on July 30th and 31st. Juveniles face off in the Governor's Cup Futurity on July 30th, led by fastest qualifier Frivolous and kindergarten finalist Mornings with Maria. On July 31st, She Goes Up will look to sweep the Governor's Cup Series with a win in the Derby. No filly has swept the Governor's Cup Series since the Great Corona Cash in 1997 and 98, plus the Spencer Childers Championship, the Matron Stakes for Mares, and many more stakes races. And remember, Los Alamitos is open for daytime simulcasting 7 days a week. Enjoy the great daytime action from Del Mar, Saratoga, and more. The best of racing. The best of quarter horse racing, always at Los Alamitos. California Breeders' Champions Weekend, July 30th and 31st.
From the tropical rainforests of Hawaii's Big Island, nature has given us Uncle Chemo's Kona Coffee, derived from a naturally occurring coffee bean that is only found in this precise altitude and climatic setting. Uncle Chemo's Kona Coffee ensures a perfect start to your day or any cherished moment from sunup to sundown. every treasured coffee bean is the result of nearly 4 years of nurturing on the 57-acre family farm in the mountains above Halu'aloha, Hawaii. And unlike many other coffee beans from the Big Island, Uncle Kimo's is estate grade and hand roasted. This means all beans are grown, picked, roasted, and packaged on the farm to ensure the beans are the most balanced and as rich in flavor as possible. Uncle Kimo's Kona Coffee is now available on the mainland. To place an order, just visit UncleKimo'sKonaCoffee.com and look for our logo on the track and in the winner's circle, along with jockeys Juan Hernandez and Tyler Bays. Fans, visit our website and you can see for yourself that Uncle Kimo's emanates from a true island paradise. Uncle Kimo's Kona Coffee, you can taste the aloha.
This segment brought to you by world-famous Red Tractin's Restaurant in Solana Beach. Visiting San Diego this weekend? Then get into Red Tractin's and discover what members of the PGA Tour, the NFL, and Major League Baseball have known for decades. The finest steaks, seafood, and nightly piano bar are all at world-famous Red Tractin's.
Welcome back. Hour one, Thoroughbred Los Angeles. Let's get to South Florida and say hello to our good friend Toby Callett. Toby, good morning. How you doing, partner?
I'm well, Mike. How are you?
Good to have you on early. Good to be back on the air. You got 10 of them, I believe, down there at Gulfstream Park today. You get underway at 9:25 our time. Set the scene.
Well, so far, all is well. We're fast, and we have Tepeda, and we've only got a few dirt races today, but the card is very playable, actually, and radio play today will be from Gulfstream. It's race seven, and in race seven, I like the one, Kenya Sun. She didn't have the best of starts last time. She switches back to her preferred jockey, Miguel Vasquez. He rides very well. He's one of the top riders here in the summertime. Look for Kenya Sun to get the job done. She's six on the morning line. She won't be a fraction of that at post time, probably two and a half, good enough for me. Behind her, we're using the 7, Hardly Social, the 6, Perfect Kimberly S, and the 4, Clip Spot. 1-7-6-4, Slam the Door on today's 7th at Gulfstream Park.
Right, and there's actually 11 today at Gulfstream. Race 7, Toby, set to go 3:34 Eastern, and Toby says it's number 1, Kenya Sun, 6-1 on the line. He doesn't think we'll get that. But let's get the win here, this four-year-old filly by Broken Vow. So much great racing going on all over the place. What's available at TobyCallett.com?
3 key plays every day they run at Gulfstream, and 3 key plays every day they run at Del Mar all the way through. They run, we write.
Toby, thank you so much, and we'll be back to a regular two-hour schedule next week. Great to have you on.
Say hello to West Coast Toby as well. Thank you.
Indeed, I will. West Coast Toby would be Toby Terrell of Winner's Card, and he joins us right now. Hey, Toby, good morning.
Good morning. Good morning, Mike.
Mr. Callett says hello. First of all, I want to get an update on Flightline. He worked 5H yesterday, I believe, in 59-2 for John Sadler. John termed it a maintenance work in preparation for the Pacific Classic Labor Day, September 3rd. Did you have him on out, maybe 7/8 or a mile?
Yeah, I mean, the thing with this horse is I don't think he knows what a maintenance drill is. In fact, when he hit the wire, he was galloping. But then, as they say, the real running somehow just began as he was going around the turn. I mean, it was an amazing turn time on the gallop out all the way back to the three-quarter pole for basically 6 furlongs in about 1:12. Just phenomenal. Just words can't even describe it.
That's just the way it is with this horse. He appears to be so incredibly talented that you run out of adjectives. At this point in time, Toby, are you going to put him up with the best you've seen?
I have to, after almost what I saw today, because now he's run several races now, brilliant races. It's not like he just ran 1 race, 2 race, 3 race kind of thing. He's now done it all. I mean, he goes back to New York. He destroyed the best they have there. And the key is, the way I see it, he's come out of that race now. Let's put it this way. He's on course and on point, certainly, to be in that category for sure.
terrific. Let's make some money here. Our time's short. Who do you like on the 10 race card today down there at the Seaside?
Well,
11 races, I mean. 11.
Yes, yeah. Mr. Baffert is loaded again. Surprise, surprise. Today, I think it all starts in race number 4 with number 7 having a meltdown.
Florent Garou in town to ride. 9-5 on John White's morning line. Toby says it's number 7 having a meltdown. If you make it down to Del Mar, pick up winner's card, the best $5 you're going to spend going to the races, or you can get it online at casetherace.com. Toby, thanks. Great to be back, and good luck today, pal.
Thanks a lot, Mike.
All right, we'll step aside. Coming back strong with the top man at Del Mar, Mr. Joe Harper. Don't go away.
The preceding is a paid program. Opinions expressed are those of the program sponsors and not necessarily the views of AMA 30, its owners, or management.
Hi, everybody. This is Juan Hernandez. If you want to break out of the gate fast like I do every morning, do what I do. Have a cup of Uncle Kimo's Kona coffee. Uncle Kimo's, you'll be glad you did.
Angels baseball is less than 2 hours away here on Angels Radio, AM 830, KLAA.
Orange County, Los Angeles, and Inland Empire.
The following is a paid program. Opinions expressed are those of the program sponsors and not necessarily the views of AM 830, its owners, or management.
Where the turf meets the surf, down at Old Del Mar, take a plane, take a train. Take a car. There's a smile on every face and a winner in each race. Where the turf meets the surf at Del Mar.
Daybreak at Del Mar is back at the Clubhouse Terrace every Saturday and Sunday during the meet from 7:30 till 9 a.m. Enjoy complimentary coffee and watch morning workouts with commentary from Michelle Yu. First post-time opening weekend is 2 p.m. Tickets can be purchased online at dmtc.com or call 858-792-4242 for details. Use your seat tickets for free admission.
Where the turf meets the surf at Del Mar.
Welcome back to Where the Surf Meets the Turf. Welcome back to Del Mar.
Racing fans, happy days are here again at Sammy's Original Off-Track Wagering, as they are now fully open for indoor dining and wagering. That's right, Sammy's Original in Lake Forest, where the 5 and the 405 collide, is once again open for off-track wagering on tracks around the country 7 days a week. Just exit east at Lake Forest Drive, make an immediate right onto Lake Center Drive, and you're home at Sammy's. Sammy's Original Sports Bar and Racebook, with over 120 televisions, great food, a full bar that includes 16 beers on tap, also offers 2 fully appointed outdoor patios. Make plans now to go racing at Sammy's Original in Lake Forest. For more information, call 949-716-2367. Get comfortable. Get into Sammy's.
Thoroughbred owners and breeders, if you're looking for a full-service, professionally managed facility right here in Southern California, look no further than George Yeager's BG Thoroughbred Farm in Hemet. From conception to starting gate, from breeding, mare care and foaling, to racetrack preparation and state-of-the-art rehabilitative care, BG Thoroughbred Farm is the place for you. Owned by George Yeager and managed by Marcos Menavar, BG Thoroughbred Farm is located atop 51 acres of prime sandy loam and is just 90 minutes from Santa Anita, Del Mar, and Los Alamitos. With a 5/8 mile training track that includes a starting gate, BG has 28 pastures with year-round grass, along with a layup barn that includes runout pens and numerous sand pens for turnouts that'll keep your horse safe and ready to return to racing. For more information or to schedule a tour, visit bgthoroughbredfarm.com or give Marcos Menavar a call at 951-654-9100. BG Thoroughbred Farm in Hemet.
Now, more than ever, it pays to own a cowbred. Owners of a registered California bred maiden shall be paid $17,500 owner's bonus for winning a maiden allowance race in Southern California and a $10,000 owner's bonus for winning a maiden allowance race in Northern California. These bonus awards are in addition to all regular purse monies won and will be paid within 30 days after the win. California bred $50,000 or less maiden claiming winners will be eligible for the current $40,000 or less starter races too. Take advantage of these tremendous new incentive programs by breeding and buying cowbreds. For information, call the California Thoroughbred Breeders Association at 626-445-7800. That's 626-445-7800. Or log on to ctba.com. And remember, it pays to own a cowbred.
If you're looking for a quick weekend getaway, or maybe you've got friends and family coming in from out of town, check out Sunset Suites on Pacific Coast Highway in Sunset Beach. Conveniently located just south of Seal Beach Boulevard, Sunset Suites gives you ready beach access and you're walking distance from outstanding breakfast, lunch, and legendary dining establishments right on Pacific Coast Highway. Just listen to some of the testimonials. It's a place like no other. Very quiet and a short walk to the beach. Very clean with all the amenities. The owners are amazing and always accommodating. We can't wait to go back. There you have it. Take the 605 to the 405 exit at Seal Beach Boulevard, west to Pacific Coast Highway, and you're there at 16401 PCH. Go ahead and get away for the day. Make your Sunset Suites reservations now at 562-592-2292. That's Sunset Suites at 562-592-2292. Life's a beach, so enjoy it at Sunset Suites.
The best of quarter horse racing continues at Los Alamitos Racecourse every Saturday and Sunday night. The nighttime summer action at Los Alamitos will feature California Breeders' Champions Weekend on July 30th and 31st. Juveniles face off in the Governor's Cup Futurity on July 30th, led by fastest qualifier Frivolous and kindergarten finalist Mornings with Maria. On July 31st, She Goes Up will look to sweep the Governor's Cup Series with a win in the Derby. No filly has swept the Governor's Cup Series since the Great Corona Cash in 1997 and 98, plus the Spencer Childers Championship, the Matron Stakes for Mares, and many more stakes races. And remember, Los Alamitos is open for daytime simulcasting 7 days a week. Enjoy the great daytime action from Del Mar, Saratoga, and more. The best of racing. The best of quarter horse racing. Always at Los Alamitos. California Breeders' Champions Weekend, July 30th and 31st.
Once again, a very pleasant good morning, everybody. Listen, we got a 30-minute show this hour owing to Angels on Deck coming up at 9:30 from Atlanta with Trent Rush. But we're going to be joined momentarily by the head guy at Del Mar for many, many years, CEO, general manager, Mr. Joe Harper. A long and storied history in this great game of thoroughbred racing. And he took the reins at Del Mar some 45 years ago, back in 1977. And a lot to talk about this morning with Joe. I want to talk a little bit about his background. I don't know how many people know this, but Joe Harper's grandfather was the legendary director-producer Cecil B. DeMille. And Joe actually had bit parts in a couple of Academy Award-winning films, The Greatest Show on Earth, which got Best Picture in 1952. And he was also depicted as a slave, a young boy in The Ten Commandments, 1959. That, of course, starred Yul Brynner and many others. That earned an Academy Award for Best Visual Effects. And for some reason, we're not able to reach Joe Harper at this point in time, but we're trying real hard. Some additional background on Joe, of course. His mom owned and bred horses for years. Joe was around the racetrack as a young guy and well-steeped in the history and lore of Del Mar. So we have him now, Jake. Oh, we're trying a third time, according to Jake Rich. Anyway, some big moments, obviously, in Del Mar history. the Pacific Classic, the inaugural back in 1991. That was huge for a lot of reasons. First of all, it was the kind of the brainchild of John Mabee, who was such a big guy at Del Mar, a big guy in business in the San Diego area, and his homebred best pal, who at that time was trained by Gary Jones, ridden by Pat Valenzuela, won the inaugural Pacific Classic back in 1991. Of course, two Breeders' Cups come to mind at Del Mar in 2017, a record-shattering Breeders' Cup, and another just tremendous Breeders' Cup in 2020. This year, a big change at Del Mar. We're moving the Pacific Classic back, I think it's great, to Labor Day, September 3rd. We have Joe Harper now, and we'll try and catch up. Hey, Joe, good morning.
Good morning, Mike. How you doing?
Well, I'm getting a little stressed because we weren't able to reach Joe Harper, but now we have Joe Harper, so that's very good.
Joe Harper, yeah. I was out taking my normal jog with my boys and didn't hear the phone, but I'm... Anyway, I'm glad to talk to you. It's been a while, and everything's okay with you.
Joe, you're off to a great start. We've talked quite a bit about the fact you set the all-time opening day record on Friday, 23.1 million. You came back yesterday at 23.2. But I want to talk a little bit about your background in the game. You know, prior to the entity, which we know as the Del Mar Thoroughbred Club, Del Mar had, you know, was founded by Bing Crosby and some friends of his in the entertainment industry back in the late 1930s, 1938. And, you know, it was, I think you've been quoted the effect when you guys took over, Del Mar was a fun place to go and everything, but it certainly wasn't anywhere near on the level of, say, a Saratoga or at that time in Arlington Park in Chicago. I think you guys were like maybe the number 22 racetrack in the country. I mean, it's been 45 incredible years, Joe, and the way this meet has started, I know it's got to be incredibly gratifying.
Yeah, it is. I mean, it really, you know, when Bing and the boys, Bob Hope and all those guys came down, what put us on the map at that time, you know, you could only go to Del Mar if you wanted to see a star. No TV in those days. And
right.
So it really, you know, and they used to, not me, but... if the train didn't show up from L.A., they'd hold the first race until it got here. So you can tell where the fans were coming from.
Exactly. And you know, I don't know if you were ever around Bing Crosby or not, but you've related some things to me over the years. He could be tough. And I know Bob Hope had a lot to say about Bing. They were the best of friends. And I remember seeing Bob Hope at Del Mar many times late in his life, Joe. What are your remembrances of those kind of people?
Well, Bob loved to come, and Dolores and her sister were actually the ones that really loved to come to the races. But they dragged Bob along. You know, he was getting pretty old then. But I loved talking to him about the old days. Yeah, and I asked him. I said, "How come all you guys used to come down here?" And he said it was Bing. Apparently,
right.
Bing had a lot of pull in Hollywood, and he was a singer, he was an actor, and he kind of got away from the studio hold. Which was so common in those days. And so when he said, come on down, we all came down. So that's, you know, it was
right.
Great for us.
Yeah, that was kind of their marching orders. And, of course, they had great times down there. And, you know, you think of Desi Arnaz and Lucille Ball, Jimmy Durante, Al Jolson. I remember seeing Phil Harris myself working there in the mid-1980s. But I want to talk a little bit about your grandfather, Cecil B. DeMille, the legendary producer, director, and you grew up in an environment where you were around these kind of people, Joe. What was Del Mar like to you as a little kid?
Well, you know, my mother had a lot of horses, and she loved to run them at Del Mar. She actually won the Futurity way back when in the early 60s. It was a lot of Hollywood was still there, but, you know, a lot of producers and things like that, But it was interesting growing up, not just in Del Mar, but in Hollywood itself. Somebody said, what was it like to grow up in Hollywood? I said, not many people actually grow up in Hollywood. They grow broke and a few other things. But it was an amazing life in those days, going to different locations and filming. I even got to be in a couple of these movies, both of them won Oscars, so I figured after two Oscar-winning performances, I'd leave. I was washed up at 13, yeah.
The Greatest Show on Earth in 52, and then the epic The Ten Commandments in 1959. Joe, I don't know how many people know this. You were also a part of one of the most popular television presentations in the history of Southern California television, and that was the old show that Joe Burnham worked on, helped produce, a Hall of Fame videographer, and it was hosted by Gil Stratton for the most part. Harry Henson called the races at Santa Anita Hollywood Park in Del Mar for the TV show, but I know that was a great experience for you.
Yeah, it certainly was. You know, I was freshly married and out of college, the college has gotten me to leave. And so I was delivering the mail at MGM Studios, and that led to being named the head of the mailroom, which I didn't think was really a good career move for me. So I bowed out of that and had nothing going on. And I ran into Joe Burnham, who I'd known and seen around the racetrack. And he said, "Why don't you come to work for me? I need a cinema photographer," which I said, "Great, I'd love to, but I've never been a cinema photographer." And he said, "Don't worry." He said, "You know enough about composition, from watching your granddaddy's movies, so I'll just teach you about f-stops and it was a marvelous time. Joe was an amazing man. He put on great shows, and as you know, Gil was terrific to work with, and it developed into great friendships that lasted for years and years, and it really kind of led to me being around the tracks all the time, and then the folks at Oak Tree finally tapped me to come and be in management, and went from there.
Yeah, I read somewhere, I think you were senior VP, something like that, for the Oak Tree Racing Association prior to the formation of the Del Mar Thoroughbred Club. When you talk about Del Mar, I think a guy named John Mabee has to be mentioned, John. He was, to me, such a big part of the development of the Del Mar Thoroughbred Club, the entire program. He was a big picture guy. Talk about some of the big developments in Del Mar history, and I think you got to talk about that first Pacific Classic in 1991.
Well, yeah, John was a terrific guy. You know, he was just a salt of the earth kind of guy. He was from the Midwest, and he and his wife Betty, they loved the horse business. They had a nice farm out there in Ramona, but he always said in those early days, he said, "We need a $1 million race that would help put us on the map." And I said, "John, you're absolutely correct." I think I said Mr. Maybe then. And he said, "Well," but I said, "we just don't have enough money in our purse structure to do that." And he said, "Well," then every month he'd ask me how that was going along. So we finally got enough money to put on a $1 million race. And guess who won it? Lo and behold, John Maybe and Best Pal. And I was so happy for him. You know, I think at the time he was probably the guy that had more horses in training than anybody in the United States. And but he loved the game, and he loved, you know, I mean, he was just such a nice guy and a very successful businessman with his market chain and then insurance business. So working under him as when he was chairman and president also, it was just so helpful and so amazing. Well, I was a very lucky guy.
He ran his Golden Eagle Farm. That was the name of his insurance company. You say he was a nice guy, but hey, Joe, he was tough. No doubt about that. He didn't get to where he got by being a nice guy, I don't think. You mentioned the market. I want to talk about a story. You can fill me in here, but John and Betty Maybe owned a very successful chain of markets. I think they sold out to Kroger. It was called Big Bear Markets. Was it 1977? Something happened with the banks, and you guys didn't have enough money on hand for a Saturday program, I believe. And John ran down to his safe deposit box and came back with some shopping bags full of cash. What, 40, 50 grand to get the day started? Is that true? What year was that?
That's that. Well, I'll tell you, it was 77, and I remember it well because it was the first year that I was down there, and this was my first big day at racing and first weekend, I think. And the truck, we needed, I think at that time, about $3 to $4 million to seed both the mutuals and the operations department. So the truck showed up with $10,000. I said, where's the rest, guys? And they said, well, this was all we got. It was a new driver. And I said, well, go back and get the rest because the crowd's going to be here pretty soon. We got to open the gate. He said, we can't get it because the time lock shut the door and it won't open until tomorrow.
Uh-oh.
Yeah, that's what I said. Uh-oh. I might have added a few other expletives after
Thank
that.
Thank you.
But anyway, I called down there and I said, you got it. Hey, guys, come on. And he said, well, we're working on a plan. We'll get back to you. So they were working on their plan. I was working on my plan. I ran into Buzzy Bavasi, who at the time was working for the Padres. And I said, Buzzy, I need some cash. You got any down there? He said, yeah, just go down and help yourself. Tell him I sent you. I said, I think you better call first. He said, but we sent one of our security guys down there, and he came back with, I don't know, $10,000-$20,000. And then I started going to all of the savings and loans in those days. Banks weren't open at those years. So that we'd send a uniformed guard over there, and we could get $10,000 from each of them. I'm thinking, you know, this would be the greatest scam in the world. Let's call them and tell them we need money, and here's our guard. But it's funny. We got quite a bit of money from that. And also I had found a bank up in L.A. that were sending it down on a truck. But I went back to the armored car company and see how they were doing with their friend. They said, we've got a plan. We're lowering a very small person on a rope down the night chute, and he can open the door from the inside. And I'm listening to this.
That's good to know.
Yeah. And I don't know where they found that small of locksmith, but they had one.
Yeah.
And while I'm listening to this on the phone, I hear in the background, please freeze. Put your hands in the air. Well, I guess the little guy on the rope tripped the alarm.
Sure.
And set it off. And so, you know, they got caught kind of robbing their own bank. And I've always thought cops coming in and seeing this guy holding a rope with a small guy down, lowering him into the vault. He said, I got to go now. I said, yeah, I bet you do. So,
he had to go.
But anyway, at the end of the day, we had more cash than we know what to do with John's, Betty's money and everything else. And the truck arrived from L.A. And it's the first time I ever saw the truck coming down the ramp that got a round of applause from the fans. So it was an interesting day and got out of it.
45 years ago, Joe Harper, great memories and more memories to come. Congrats on a tremendous start, and congrats on moving the Pacific Classic back to September 3rd. Looking forward to seeing Flight Lion and so many others. Hoping for a great meet. 7 weeks of some of the best racing in America. Joe Harper, thanks so much.
Great. Thanks, Mike.
You bet.
Good to see you.
You bet. We're going
to
step aside one final time in this half hour. Coming back strong with Bruce Finkelstein. He's got some opinions, not only on our card, but we're heading up north as well. Don't go away.
Angels Radio. AM 830.
From the tropical rainforests of Hawaii's Big Island, nature has given us Uncle Chemo's Kona Coffee, derived from a naturally occurring coffee bean that is only found in this precise altitude and climatic setting. Uncle Chemo's Kona Coffee ensures a perfect start to your day or any cherished moment from sunup to sundown. Every treasured coffee bean is the result of nearly 4 years of nurturing on the 57-acre family farm in the mountains above Halu'aloha, Hawaii. And unlike many other coffee beans from the Big Island, Uncle Chemo's is estate-grade and hand-roasted. This means all beans are grown, picked, roasted, and packaged on the farm to ensure the beans are the most balanced and as rich in flavor as possible. Uncle Chemo's Kona Coffee is now available on the mainland. To place an order, just visit UncleChemo'sKonaCoffee.com. And look for our logo on the track and in the winner's circle, along with jockeys Juan Hernandez and Tyler Bays. Fans, visit our website, and you can see for yourself that Uncle Chemo's emanates from a true island paradise. Uncle Chemo's Kona Coffee, you can taste the aloha.
Attention Inland Empire racing fans. Watching and wagering on the races just got easier. The Derby Room located at Fairplex Park is open and ready to serve you. Watch and wager in the newly renovated Derby Room on races across the country starting at 9 a.m. each Wednesday through Sunday. Televisions throughout the Derby Room will keep you up to date on all sporting events. Add in great food and a great atmosphere, and you'll have the ultimate horse player experience. For upcoming promotions, go to thederbyroom.com. Thederbyroom.com. See you at the Derby Room, 2201 North White Avenue in Pomona.
Where the turf meets the surf, where the turf meets the surf, down at Old Del Mar.
catching a fast train or jumping in your car. Come on, Gilmore. Everybody's gonna have a smile on their face, cause somebody's gonna win every single time there's a race. When it's turf meets a surf down the Old Del Mar. When it's turf meets a surf, where the turf meets a surf down the Old Del Mar. Where the turf meets a surf.
Easy Thursdays are back. Free stretch run admission, free program, and a free seat every Thursday during the Del Mar meet. Add pints of Coors Light for just $6, and Thursdays are always a winning daily double. 4 o'clock Friday start July 29th with half-off signature drinks starting with the gates open until 2 hours after first post. You can pre-purchase seats at dmtc.com or call 858-792-4242 for details. See you where the surf meets the turf. Del Mar, still cool as ever.
Where the turf meets the surf down the Old Del Mar. Where the turf meets the surf,
all right now.
Down at Old Del Mar.
Nearly 50 years ago, Len Ragazin formulated the idea of speed ratings. Today, the Ragazin sheets are still America's premier speed rating product. Who uses Len Ragazin speed ratings? Trainers use the Ragazin sheets to place their horses. Breeders check the Ragazin sheets before making million-dollar decisions. And jockey agents consult the Ragazin sheets when choosing which horse to ride. But most importantly, the Ragazin sheets are used by players like you. The Ragazin sheets are available online at thesheets.com. Our website also offers free introductory material, including an online seminar. You can also receive free introductory material by calling us directly at 212-674-3123. That's the Ragazin sheets at 212-674-3123. Ragazin, the most respected name in racing. From the tropical rainforests of Hawaii's Big Island, nature has given us Uncle Chemo's Kona Coffee. Derived from a naturally occurring coffee bean that is only found in this precise altitude and climatic setting, Uncle Chemo's Kona Coffee ensures a perfect start to your day or any cherished moment from sunup to sundown. Every treasured coffee bean is the result of nearly 4 years of nurturing on the 57-acre family farm in the mountains above Halu'aloha, Hawaii. And unlike many other coffee beans from the Big Island, Uncle Chemo's is estate-grade and hand-roasted. This means all beans are grown, picked, roasted, and packaged on the farm to ensure the beans are the most balanced and as rich in flavor as possible. Uncle Chemo's Kona Coffee is now available on the mainland. To place an order, just visit UncleChemo'sKonaCoffee.com. And look for our logo on the track and in the winner's circle, along with jockeys Juan Hernandez and Tyler Bays. Fans, visit our website, and you can see for yourself that Uncle Chemo's emanates from a true island paradise. Uncle Chemo's Kona Coffee, you can taste the aloha.
Want to bet your favorite horse but can't make it to the race book? South Point Casino's race book has the answer. Come in and sign up for the Nevada Racebook mobile app. For just a $50 minimum deposit, you'll have the racebook right at your fingertips, no matter where you are in Nevada. It's convenient, fun, and easy to use. When you do have time to visit, South Point Casino is the perfect place to be. Our racebook is completely separate from the sportsbook and totally dedicated to the horse player. With 52 overhead TVs, free Wi-Fi, and cocktail service, bring your tablet or smartphone and plug into the USB ports to look up your favorite handicapping website without draining your battery. Want to wager from your seat? No problem with our IPTs. Just sign up, make a deposit, and you're off to the races. Plus, you'll earn points for dining, hotel, movies, entertainment, and the spa just by using the club card when wagering. Whether you want to come in or play from the comfort of your home, South Point Casino's Racebook has you covered.
If you're looking for a quick weekend getaway, or maybe you've got friends and family coming in from out of town, check out Sunset Suites on Pacific Coast Highway in Sunset Beach. Conveniently located just south of Seal Beach Boulevard, Sunset Suites gives you ready beach access and your walking distance from outstanding breakfast, lunch, and legendary dining establishments right on Pacific Coast Highway. Just listen to some of the testimonials. It's a place like no other. Very quiet and a short walk to the beach. Very clean with all the amenities. The owners are amazing and always accommodating. We can't wait to go back. There you have it. Take the 605 to the 405 exit at Seal Beach Boulevard, west to Pacific Coast Highway, and you're there at 16401 PCH. Go ahead and get away for the day. Make your Sunset Suites reservations now at 562-592-2292. That's Sunset Suites at 562-592-2292. Life's a beach, so enjoy it at Sunset Suites.
This segment brought to you by world-famous Red Tractins Restaurant in Solana Beach. Visiting San Diego this weekend? Then get into Red Tractins and discover what members of the PGA Tour, the NFL, and Major League Baseball have known for decades. The finest steaks, seafood, and nightly piano bar are all at world-famous Red Tractins.
And when you get into Reds, tell them you heard about it here on Thoroughbred Los Angeles. Short segment. Let's go to Bruce Finkelstein up in Las Vegas on behalf of BetOnBruce.com. Hey, Bruce, what do you got for us?
Good morning, Mike. Hey, let's go to the eighth race in Sacramento real quick. That's the finale. I like the two-horse in here, A Man's Man. He has never been better. He got reacquainted with the dirt last time out and had a crushing win at Pleasanton. I think he can come right back again. So in the eighth race, the two, A Man's Man, and... Let's switch over to Del Mar, Mike, for the third race.
Real quick, Bruce.
The six horse, All About the Money, really ran well despite a slow pace last time out. He's sharp right now, gets the apprentice. Race three, the six, All About the Money.
Next week we got more time. Bruce, have a great day and hope you're enjoying Del Mar.
You got it, man. Take care.
You bet. My thanks to Jake Rich inside here, Leilani Mabry. Angels on Deck with Trent Rush is next up, and it'll be the Halos against the Braves it'll be the bottom of the hour, at top of the hour, rather. Hope you enjoyed the show. We enjoyed being back. See ya.
You have been listening to Thoroughbred Los Angeles, brought to you by world-famous Red Tractors Restaurant in Solana Beach and by the all-new Bit Tavern in South Arcadia, just off the corner of 10th and Live Oak. Beer me at the Bit.
The preceding was a paid program. Opinions expressed are those of the program sponsors and not necessarily the views of AM830 KLAA, its owners, or management. Any and all on-air promotions broadcast during paid programming are the sole responsibility of the show owner and not the responsibility of AM830 KLAA.
Live on game day, here to get you ready for Angels baseball, it's Angels on Deck with Trent Rush.
2-2 pitch. Ohtani lifts this one. Left field. Home run. That one hit well towards the...